So good morning everyone. So here we are. We are in the Trailhead login. Trailhead is an official web application from Salesforce to learn different skills. And here in this, let me take the pointer. Everyone will be signing up with their personal email address, that is Gmail. And you will be going through with this modules. Here, Trailhead, as I mentioned, it is one of the Salesforce web applications to learn the current trends and skills. If I go to Trail, I'm following this from 2017. So when I started off, it was around 8 or 10 trails, but as of today, it is 239 different trails. Each trail is made up of modules and each module is made up of topics. So let us take one example. Let us take a trail, learn marketing best practices. If I open this trail, I have modules. If I go to the module, I'll be getting the topics. So each topic, you have to read it because it's better to read. And this top entire module is for 500 points, means each one will have 100 points where you need to open it, read it, understand it, and attempt the exam. First attempt will be 100 points, second attempt 50, third attempt 25, and it keeps going. So it will be 25 and 25. That is the least one. So in the same way, we have credentials where we have super badges, certifications, and more. Community is there. If you want to know more about the communities, we have companies. This is only for the Trailhead, for the companies. And at last, we have something called, which is related to COVID, how it will help us. Coming to the first one, that is the homepage. We'll be given with all the modules and other stuff, modules, trails, and others, so that if people can learn about it. So it's huge list of modules which have been present. So each trail is composed of modules. Modules is composed of topics. Along with that, what is it you people can make use of is Trailhead Live, which has videos. If you want to view these videos, you have to have a sign up here. On the right top, we have the profile, which has badges and the points. If I go to the profile, this is one of the favorites now. Every organization which is going, they will ask you to provide this link, which is a unique link, which will tell you the number of trails completed. Out of 239, I have completed only 21 trails. There is a lot to learn. 92,962 points and others. If you want to know where do you stay and what is your ranger, you can see this one. This is ranger. 50,000 points. 100 badges will make you a ranger. Both should be satisfied. Above that, it will be called as 2x, 3x and more, means 200 badges, 1 lakh. 300 badges, 1,50,000. 200 badges, 400 badges, 2 lakh points. Then it will be 4x ranger. Ranger is the maximum one, and then keep on adding it. 100 badges, 50 points. 200 badges, 1 lakh points. 300 badges, 1,50,000 points. 400 badges, 2 lakh points. If I have 400 badges and 2 lakhs, it's not or, it is and 2 lakhs, then it will be 4x ranger. That is about the Trailhead points. Coming to certifications, I am 8x certified, where we need to pay amount. Take the certification, which is $200 per certification for the first attempt. Second attempt, so you can see there are Salesforce Marketing Cloud Developer maintenance is due. There is a lot of maintenance which I need to maintain. So if I go to Salesforce Marketing Cloud Administrator, it is active. Salesforce Marketing Cloud Email Specialist, it is maintenance due. If I click on this, I'll be getting a module, I need to read it and complete it, then only my certification will be active. So it should be an active certification, and two of them are expired in my case because I did not maintain it, so it is expired. One is retired, no one can take the certification because they have removed it. So exactly same way I am. So according to this, I am 6x certified, not 8x, because one is retired, the other one is expired. So maintain your certifications because you have earned it by paying $200 or more. And I'm 4x super badges. I have 4 super badges. And this super badges, you need to read the requirement and do it. So I'll guide you on all those things. So I'm 1x ranger, 6x Salesforce certified, 4x super badges. Make sense? Hope everyone is clear till here. Now, how do we get these certifications? If you want to get this certification, you need to book a certification which will be in Salesforce Web Accessor. Salesforce. So this is a third party vendor who maintains their exams and conducting the exams. Salesforce Web Accessor, if you log into this. So when I created under the name of my company at that point of time as a username. I would suggest you people to do it as a generic one. This is my first employer with respect to Marketing Cloud. Here I'm NC, and here is my password. Follow the password policy and login. I have booked a certification exam. So if I go to my assessments, you can see that I have booked a certification, that is Marketing Cloud Consultant online on 18th February was the date of registration. 8th of May is the date of exam. If I scroll down, you can see all the times I have attempted it. Salesforce Certified Pardot Consultant, I have attempted it, but I couldn't clear it. I have attempted Salesforce Certified Pardot Consultant, I couldn't clear it. So I have attempted 1, 2, 3 times. So consultant is not easy. So don't worry about these things. Concentrate on Salesforce Marketing Cloud Email Specialist. When I took it for the first time, it was 21st April, 9th June and 26th June. 26th June is when I cleared it. So it's a history that I don't clear any of the certifications for the first time. And then Marketing Cloud Consultant, I attempted 1, 2, 3 times. And then I cleared in the month of December. It's consultant, it's not easy. So don't worry about the amount. So here comes $200, $100, $100. Exactly same way, $200, $100, $100 and $100. If you calculate this, what is the amount it will be? So it will be 200 plus 100 plus 100, totally 400 plus 500. So it's $900 which I've spent to become a Salesforce Marketing Cloud Consultant. 2 attempts, 3 attempts for email specialist, 4 attempts to become a consultant. Exactly it goes with others, I have to maintain it, okay? So my agenda is, I might not clear in first attempt. It doesn't mean that everyone will not clear in first attempt. So you should use this, and I'll guide you people when you people are taking those exams. That is not an issue. So I would request you people to mention all the details. I'll be guiding each one of you people after this recording is completed. That is about Trailhead and Salesforce Web Accessor. Your Salesforce Web Accessor will be linked with this Trailhead, and it will tell you what is that we need to do here. Make sense? So if I go to this certification maintenance, I have to maintain it so that I'm not losing my money. And this maintenance is free. You need not have to pay for this. You need to just make sure that you are clicking it, read the module, complete it. It's only one thing, which is for 500 points. Means they have said something as an exercise. I have to read it. I have to complete it, and then I'll be going with checking the challenge of it. Okay. So exactly same way, all the things which has to be maintained, I have to go there, and I have to keep on clicking on this and maintain it. It should be called as present, which I'll be completing after this session. So this is about Trailhead and how we will be ranked here. Coming to the modules, I'll be creating a database and then we'll be going with this modules. I'll be guiding you people on these modules also. What should be picked and how you should go through with these things. That is related to your Trailhead and Salesforce Web Accessor. Anyone has any questions, let me know. If not, I'll be stopping this recording for a while. Great. Coming to Salesforce Marketing Cloud, what is that you should be keeping in mind always with any industry? You might work with finance, you might work with banking sector, insurance, you might work with closely to hospitals or medical industry, pharma, it might be a car manufacturing company, they might be using it like Benz. I've heard about they are using it, Benz, Audi, or it might be Ferrari who are using it. It might be the industries like service industries, for example, Swiggy, Zomato, wallets like Paytm, PhonePe, they might be using it. Many people might be using it. Lending companies like Bajaj Finserv is using it. Up to my knowledge, Tata Capital is using it. I'm not sure about it. But Reliance, with respect to Reliance and Jio, they are using Salesforce technologies as much as possible. Okay. So this is about the industry, any industry. So it starts, everything comes and begins with data. You have to collect data, collect. After collecting, obviously you need to store it. When you start storing more and more data, you need to maintain it. This is the reason we are learning SQL. Next, if you want to collect data, we need web technology. Like, if you are a programmer, you should learn HTML, CSS. HTML, CSS. You need to learn JavaScript and its libraries and server-side scripting language. Server-side scripting language. So don't worry, I'll be discussing each one of you. I'll pick up you people individually. Server-side scripting and more. Coming to the JS, that is the JavaScript part. This is purely for the programmers, everyone. So we have many things to learn here, like basics of JavaScript, jQuery, AngularJS, and more if required. When I say server-side script, we have many languages like PHP, Ruby. We have Java Enterprise Edition. We have Java Enterprise Edition. I still hear it as J2EE, but there are many new versions which are coming up. We have C# language or ASP. ASP.NET, we have SFMC, in which we are learning or we should learn AmScript language, SSJS, GTL. These are the server-side scripting languages which we will use. So you have a huge list here. With respect to Salesforce Marketing Cloud, we need to learn these two languages minimum. GTL, will explore it. Okay. So last but not the least, we need to automate. We need to automate the process. We have many other tools to learn it. So data, we need to learn web basics, automate the process. To automate the process, If you want to automate data process, if you want to automate data, let me call it as automate data, we use Automation Studio. If I want to automate email sends, basically we'll be using Journey Builder, but both are overlaps with some places. I'll discuss on that. Now we need three things: data, web, and automate. Correct? If I want to do data, we need to do it in Email Studio or Contact Builder, or it might be both. If I want to deal with web, I need to go with Web Studio. Under this, it is Cloud Pages. For automating, we have two tools. One is called as Automation Studio. We have Journey Builder. When we start deep diving into each concept, we'll know more. So Email Studio, we have to learn it. Contact Builder, we have to learn it. Web Studio, Automation Studio, Journey Builder. And every industry wants to get some reporting. And last but not the least, we are learning Salesforce Marketing Cloud. Then we need to learn email build. And to do this, we have Email Studio, in which we have content. When I use the arrow or greater symbol, it is the subtab. We need to learn Content Builder. Both are the same. Okay, there are two different tools. So we need to learn about data. We need to learn about web. Web I'll be placing at the last because this is not required for your certification. What is required is Email Studio, Automation Studio knowledge, Journey Builder knowledge, Email Studio, Content knowledge, and Content Builder knowledge. This is not a part of our certification. So don't worry about this. We will learn it. Okay. Specific to becoming a developer. So the second certification is admin. Third certification is developer or consultant. So let me draw that. What is the entry level? If you want to become a marketer, if you want to enter as a marketer, we need the first certification, which is email specialist. After becoming email specialist, you can appear for admin, that is Marketing Cloud Admin. If you clear Marketing Cloud Admin, then you can appear for Marketing Cloud Consultant. If you are an email specialist, you can appear for Marketing Cloud Developer. Without becoming email specialist, you cannot appear for Marketing Cloud Admin or Marketing Cloud Developer. If you want to become consultant, email specialist is the first, Marketing Cloud Admin is the second certification, Marketing Cloud Consultant is the third certification. Plan, if you are looking career in Marketing Cloud, plan this within December 2021. Means keep a plan for every 3 months. This is in the month of September. It depends. This is for my core team. And before June 2021 is this. So 3 months and one. So that's how I plan for my career. Okay. Thank you. I'll be stopping this recording for now.